Hello, we are here today to show you a very old generation called
the Ants and Egypt.
Villages that exist along the river are grouped into two kingdoms, the Upper and the Lower Egypt.
The organization of the Egyptian state was made by a king or pharaoh who had absolute power. He was the owner of lands, the symbol of national unit, and god to his subjects. His authority was unquestioned.
His power was based on the control and direction of the canalization. The pharaoh was usually a man.
Now we are going to talk a little bit about Cleopatra. Many years ago existed in Egypt a beautiful queen who was famous not only for his beauty, also for her intelligence and great ability to govern the country.
Why don't we talk about gods?
Yes!
In the ancient Egypt were more than 7,000 gods. The role was the sun god. The statue was adored by a pharaoh. Esment was now a theater.
Only? No, Serket formed patron of magic. Seshat was the lady of the books. Set was the god of the force. She was the king of the earth.
And the Nile? We forgot the Nile.
The Nile is the largest river in Africa, which is 1,853 kilometers, and it flows into the Mediterranean Sea.
What the Egyptians eat?
They eat peas, meat, bread, fruit, vegetables, and also beer. Let's go to the sky park. Irene, can you talk about the movies?
Yes. In the ancient Egypt, we believe that a theater begins a journey to the afterlife to start a new life. So when the pharaoh or important people died, instead of burning them quickly, they did much to express his body and could start a new life. Let's talk about the pyramids. Laura.
The pyramids are one of the most impressive monuments we left in the Egyptian people. Thousands of laborers worked for years to build a pyramid, which would tomb the pharaoh. The largest pyramids are these: Cheops, Chephren, and Mycerinus. One of the most visited monuments is the Sphinx, which is a mixture of lion body and a head of a Egyptian. It means living imagine. Thanks for watching.
Bye bye.
Shagalat wa trabaj alon tu